Someone once said, if it rained brains, Roxy Robinson wouldn't even get wet. In all of New York, you couldn't get much dumber than Roxy the Weasel. To be frank, he was a dope. Dumb as Roxy was, he could smell trouble, like other people could smell gas. But he should never have taken that blind alley by the side of Perito's bakery. Whatever game it was people were playing, sure as eggs are eggs, Roxy Robinson was well and truly scrambled. Now, the guy in the chair here is Flash Frankie, the best lawyer in New York. Sure, he's a little shady, but he's the best, believe me. Flash Frankie's silver tongue can get a guy out of jail quicker than a truckload of dynamite. Now, as you can see, something kind of fishy's going on here. I mean, the play's only just begun, and already the stage is full of stiffs. Oh yeah, you're most probably wondering who I am. The name's Malone. Bugsy Malone.
He's a sinner, candy-coated. For all his friends, he always seems to be
mother, an Irish father, I'll naturally grow up a little confused. But I soon didn't see much future as spaghetti waiter on Mama Luchini's, or pushing a pen at City Hall. So I went from this and that, walking the line, trying hard to not fall either side. That is, one night, I walked into this place, Pop Beckett's bookstore. Hey, how are you doing? I'm Bugsy Malone. You're a singer, a dancer, right? Oh, baseball player.
Zip the lip, Wisey. I'm a noble for a conversation.
You don't like me.
Listen, Wisey, I'm surprised you don't stoop with all that dandruff on your shoulders.
Every time we come back tomorrow.
Now, you might be wondering what kind of crazy place this is, with people disappearing into bookcases. Well, firstly, this neighborhood ain't for dumb bums. And secondly, this bookstore ain't no bookstore. This is Fat Sam's place. Fat Sam's Grand Slam. The liveliest joint in town.
Go. Anybody who is, anybody will soon walk through that door. At Fat Sam's Grand Slam. Speak easy, always able to find you a table that's room for just one more. At Fat Sam's Grand Slam, speak easy. Once you get here, feel the good cheer like they say in the poem. Fat Sam's ain't humble, but it's your home sweet home. Plans to make your games to play your I could write me a book. Each night astounds you, ruins phones are buzzing, stories by dozen, look around your cousin, and news are making you. Anybody who is, anybody will soon walk through that door at Grand Slam's Grand Slam Speakeasy. La 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 la. Oh yeah, oh yeah, la 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 la. See the politicians standing by the kitchen, seven copper strings and the water was missing. Once again you feel the good cheer like they say in the poem. Bad times ain't humble, but it's your home sweet home. Plans are made, your games are played, your eye could drive me a fool. Each night is star with you, rumors are buzzing, stories by a dozen, look around your cousin and news are making you. Anybody who is, anybody will soon walk through that door at Bad Times Grand Slam Speakeasy.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm truly sorry. Oh, it's you, Dandruff.
Oh, don't worry. I had a shampoo since the last time we spoke. That bat could be classified as a dangerous weapon, you know.
My mother made me pack it.
You a sports nut?
It's for protection in case I get robbed.
Well, you're a singer, right?
That depends on your taste in music. I'm here about a job.
Did you get the job?
They said come back tomorrow.
Oh, don't worry. You always do. What's your name, anyway?
Brown.
Sounds like a loaf of bread.
Yeah. Blousy Brown.
Sounds like a stale loaf of bread.
Keep your jokes behind your teeth, Wisey.
Pleased to meet you. I'm Bugsy Malone.
Freeze!
Okay, everybody, it's okay. Nothing to worry about now. Back to the tables. Razzmatazz. Music. I want to see everybody enjoying themselves. Free drinks on the house. Just a little excitement, that's all. No one can say Fats Andy, the liveliest joint in town. Knuckles just means trouble.
Robinson was a victim of a sensational event, and we go over to a reporter on the spot for a...
So, tell me how it allows to happen. Roxy was one of my best. What have you got to say for yourselves, a bunch of dummies? Knuckles, Ritzy, Angelo, Snake Eyes, Calcium Hoodlums, you're a disgrace to your profession. Do you hear me? A disgrace. And most of all, you're a disgrace to me. Fat Sam. We all know what's behind all this, don't we?
Sure, boss.
Don't need a hat full of brains to know that, do you?
We
all know he's mucking us around, don't we?
Sure do, boss.
So who is it, you dummies?
Dan,
boss. Don't you dare mention his name in this office!
Mr. Sam, about my audition. You said come back tomorrow.
Am I going mad? I mean, he's playing tricks on me. Come back tomorrow, Fizzy.
But today is tomorrow, boss.
Fizzy, you better get out of here.
Okay, boss.
You okay, boss?
Take it easy, boss. You break something.
Break something? Sure, I'll break something, Snake Eyes. I'll break your dumb neck. Dancers, dancers. I'm surrounded by namby-pamby dancers. Singers, piano players, banjo players, tin whistle players. A Tom Riley brain, do you hear me? Brains. Brains and muscle.
You got us, boss.
Where do I get on?
Come on. You manure face. You great hunk of lard! Your trouble is, you got muscles where you ought to have brains. I tell you, my pet canary's got more brains than you dumb salami. So, what's so funny?
Nothing, boss.
Can I give you a lift?
You got a car?
No.
Then how are you gonna give me a lift, Buster? Put me in an elevator?
Tonight. We can walk. Which way are you going?
Which way are you going?
This way.
Well, I'm going this way.
Oh, at least let me carry a bag for you. You eating?
Ever since I was a child.
Then how come you're so skinny, Smarty?
I watch my weight.
Yeah, I do that when I'm broke, too. You hungry?
No.
You're not hungry?
No. Starving.
Going back to Speakeasy tomorrow?
No. I'm gonna try and get my luck at the Bijou Theater.
Oh, the Lena Morelli show.
She's walked out. They're looking for a replacement.
Oh, she walks out every week. And every week they hold auditions. And every week she walks back again. Oh, don't let me put you off.
You won't. What do you do?
Oh, this and that.
Oh, crooked, huh?
No, not quite. I find fighters, boxers. Used to be one myself. Pretty good, too.
You were?
Yeah, but for a couple of things.
Like what?
Like jelly legs and glass jaw.
Some champion.
Well, I'll do well for a couple of rounds, but I was as tough as a ball of cotton wool. This glass has more glass in it than Macy's window. One punch was enough to send me back to the dressing room, generally on a stretcher. They slapped my face and bring out the smelling salts. It was a lucky punch. How many more times can it be a lucky punch? So I wised up before my face looked like a plate of mashed potato. I could have been a contender, Charlie. We'll have two banana boozles with double ice cream, chocolate sauce and nuts, two Arizona donuts, and a Coke with two straws.
Freeze!
We can't go on meeting like this.
Later. Show them in. Hi, boys. Okay, relax. I'd like to take this opportunity for thanking you for all your work so far. Everything's gone swell. Just swell.
Thanks, boss.
Fat Sam is in for quite a shock. Bronx Charlie, laughing boy, shoulders, yonkers. I'll give yours later, okay? Soon, Fat Sam will be crawling on his knees to me.
Where's my shoulders, boss?
Soon, all Fat Sam will have is the clothes he stands up in and a suitcase full of memories. You goof doodle, you dropped the gun. And I don't allow mistakes in this outfit, because mistakes can cause us all the caboose, and Sing Sing ain't my style.
Boss.
Button your lip, Doodle. You're all washed up. Hit it, boys.
Give me a break, boss.
Fizzy.
Name is Tilly. Name is Loretta. Name is Bangles.
Night, Fizzy.
Stop cracking your knuckles, Knuckles.
That's how I got my name, boss.
Well, knock it off or change your name. Trula, you ready yet? How much longer do you want us to wait?
Coming, honey. You don't want me looking a mess, do you?
Boss, how about my audition?
Later, Fizzy. I'm busier now. Keep practicing. I'll see you tomorrow. I promise you, tomorrow.
But yesterday you said tomorrow, boss.
Tallulah, you spend more time peering yourself up there's time of the day.
Look, honey, if I didn't look this good, you wouldn't give me the time of day.
I'll see you in the car. Don't do that, Knuckles.
Night, Miss Tallulah.
Night, Fizzy.
Tomorrow never comes. What kind of a fool did they take me for? Tomorrow, a resting place for bums, a trap set in the slums, but I know the score. I won't take no for an answer. I was born to be a dancer now. Yeah. Tomorrow, as they say, another working day and another chore. Tomorrow, an awful price to pay. I gave up yesterday, but they still want more. They are bound to compare me to Fred Astaire when I'm done. Yeah. Anyone who feels the rhythm moving through them knows it's gonna do them good to let the music burst out. When you feel it sure, let the people know it. Let your laughter loose until your scream becomes a love shout. Tomorrow's far away. Tomorrow, as they say, is reserved for dreams. Tomorrow's looking gray. I gave up yesterday, but they still want more. I won't take no for an answer. I was born to be a dancer now, yeah. Anyone feels the river moving through the nose, it's gonna do them good to let the music down. When you feel assured, let the people know it. Let your laughter loose until your scream becomes a love shout. Ah.
Good evening. I am the great Malpini. I have been privileged to obtain second billings in theatres in Missouri, Paula Bluff, and Norfolk, Nebraska. And I will now perform for you a trick seen before only by the crowned heads of Europe. From this hat, I will produce not one rabbit, not two rabbits, but three rabbits!
Next! Don't give up your day job!
Oh, I wish they'd hurry up. I'm getting nervous waiting.
Oh, quit worrying, will you?
I didn't count on this many people.
Oh, these are a bunch of conjurers and magicians by the looks of it. You got no competition, believe me.
How do I look?
You look great.
I look a wreck. Blousy Brown, singer.
Hello, everybody.
Hello, are you Clarence?
Don't ask. I suppose you're wondering why I'm here.
You bet. Next!
What does he mean, next? Doesn't he know who we are? Doesn't he like us? Put the sucker on the nose. What a ding-dong. Big Sweet's Onions Prime.
Blousy Brown, singer.
Yeah, the light, honey, the light.
Oh, sorry, Mr. DeVault, I didn't catch that.
The light, honey, the light. Move into the light. This musical ain't set in a mine shaft. Name?
Blousy Brown, singer.
Cheer up, will ya? There's millions of other jobs.
Sure, on the street corner with a hat to catch the dimes in.
So it's a matter of time. Look, cool down, will ya?
I've been walking the streets of New York for 6 months now, and the only fancy steps I've done so far is avoiding the man who collects the rent.
So it takes time to be a movie star. We can just come back tomorrow.
Come back tomorrow. That's all I ever hear. I spent my whole life coming back tomorrow.
Look, Blousy, cool down, will ya?
I will not cool down.
Look, it's always Fat Sam's place.
He won't see me.
I'll talk to him.
You know him?
Yeah, well, like that.
Real good friends?
No, it's just whenever I talk to him, I cross my fingers that he won't hit me.
We interrupt tonight's commentary on tonight's exciting Red Sox ball game to bring you a further bulletin and developments on the outbreak of hoodlum gang warfare. Please now officially state the weapon of devious foreign manufacture known as the splurge gun. It has been widely used around the mobster gangs. We interrupt our interruption to go straight over to reporter Seymour Scoop, who is at the spot of the latest splurging.
Have you located the splurge gun yet, Lieutenant?
I'm afraid I can't answer that.
Not able to say.
No, I don't know the answer.
Have you located the source yet, Lieutenant?
Sure, I have my hamburger for lunch.
No, the source of the gun.
Oh, yeah. I'm not able to say. You have to ask Captain Smoke down the system.
Okay, Jerry, break this crowd up. This is police business, and police business we gotta do.
Seymour Scoop, RTZ Radio. Have you located the splurge gun yet?
No comment.
Have you located the source?
No comment.
Is it true the gun's only been used by one gang?
No comment.
I think you passed around the right time, Chief.
No comment. Get out of here.
Okay, now we know there are five guys here. What else did you see?
Nothing. I see nothing.
Well, you must have seen something.
Nothing. Honestly, Mr. Park, I see nothing. I came on the boat just this year. I got papers. I just listened to music and my business. I don't need cement overcoat. Captain, I found something.
What is it, Adrian?
A brush, Captain.
No, what have you found?
A footprint, Captain.
What type of footprint?
A big footprint, Captain.
Knucklehead! I sent you on a 6-month ring recall, and all you can tell me is that it's a big footprint. I'm not a brain Irish DuPont!
As you can probably gather, Smallskin O'Dreary have as much chance of solving this case as I have of becoming the President of the United States. Meanwhile, back to our story. Sam's definitely getting a little nervous. I mean, if you had a gang of dumb bums, you'd be nervous.
Been anything that we want it to be, and don't it make your heart glad that we decided a fact we take pride in, to become the best at being bad. Been anything that we want it to be, with all the talent we have. No doubt about it, we won and we tore it. We're the very best at being bad guys. We're rotten to the core. My congratulations, no one likes you anymore. Bad guys, we're the very worst. Each of us contemptible, we're criticized and cursed. We make the big time malicious and bad. We're the very best at being bad. We could have been anything that we wanted to be, but not the easy way out. The day was training, we mastered complaining. Mama sees the necessary. We're so rude, it's almost scary. We could have been anything that we wanted to be, with all the talent we have. With little practice, we made every blacklist. We're the very best at being bad. We're the very best at being bad. We're the very best at being bad.
What the heck is going on here, you dummies? Can I believe my eyes? Bunch of peanut brains! Get up here! Pronto! Snap it! Get your legs moving in this direction! Quit throwing the dice, Nick, guys! And quit cracking the knuckles, Knuckles.
Sorry, boss.
I swear I'm surrounded by a bunch of nervous wrecks. Right, let's start at the beginning. We're being outsmarted by that Gracie Lounge lizard, right?
Right, boss.
And get right back on top, right?
Right back on top, boss.
We're gonna kick that drugstore cowboy right in the line.
You bet, boss.
Sure, we've been able to soften the mark, but when it comes to crunch, no dumb bums we ain't.
No dumb bums we ain't.
Now I'm gonna tell you, knuckleheads, where we're going wrong. Louis, stand against the wall. Are you Shakedown Louie?
That's me, boss.
The same Shakedown Louie used to be called Harvey Spleen Decker before I gave you the name Shakedown Louie?
Sure I am, boss.
Stand against the wall, Porridge Brain. Knuckles, hand me the can.
The can, boss? What did I do wrong, boss? Talk to me. Tell me what I did wrong.
Did nothing, Louie. Nothing. See what I mean? Missed. Okay, Louie, you can sit down now. See? Even a dumb mug like Louie's too quick for us. That's the root of our trouble. We're behind the times. Knuckles, we're never going to get back on top of this kind of hardware. It's old-fashioned, obsolete, defunct. In short, we've got to get ourselves that gun.
Hello, Sam.
Yeah, stop, Gavin.
I have no idea the gun.
Spill, Shady, spill.
Do you know the whole bush in Nambri?
On E 14th Street?
Yeah, the second floor behind the laundry.
Thanks, Shady. I'll see you okay. Good boy. This is good news. I'll be sending my boys.
Good work, Shady. You've earned your money.
Thank you.
Sam's boys are in for quite a party. Now get out of here. Shoulders, there's one thing I can't decide. Is it you, Tiny Canary? Day's work, my Rose. Just the day's work. Like running a railway or shoeing a horse.
Sam ain't gonna like this, honey.
He ain't going to do nothing about it. Without his gang, Sam's like a tortoise without his shell. Soon he'll be thrown in the towel.
Whole gang? Everybody? Louis, Snake Eyes, and Richie? I don't believe it. I just don't believe it. There's the whole gang gone, Knuckles. Splurge. Leave just you and me. Just you and me, Knuckles. We're on our own.
What are you gonna do, boss?
You play it cool. You relax. 2-2 casa, sono buono.
What's that mean?
You don't speak Italian?
No.
So you call yourself a hoodlum, you don't even speak Italian. Play it cool, you relax, carry on as normal. Go see what it is, Knuckles. Act normal.
Come back tomorrow, lady.
No, wait, honey, wait! We act normal, right? So acting normal means acting normal. Be right there, honey, make yourself comfortable. We'll be a couple of minutes. Go powder your nose or something. See? Just like normal. That way, they won't know that we're scared to death. Scared. We're concerned. We buy ourselves a little time. Thinking time. Right, Knuckles? Come over here. I'm gonna send for someone to help us out in our little predicament. No 10-cent dummy. A specialist.
Doctor?
No, not a doctor, you bilberry. A hoodlum.
I thought we was the boss.
This guy's no dumbums, Knuckles. He's the real McCoy.
Isn't he Bugsy?
The very same. Mad as a hatter. Office Charlie Bugsy. Best man in Chicago. Right, here's what we do. We arrange a meeting with Dan. Bugsy will be in the back of the car next to me. You drive. You don't drive, you motorhead. Hello, is this Danny Dan's residence? I'd like to speak to himself, please. This is Stan Cicchetto. Don't ask him what it's about, fella. He'll know me. You don't drive? Then we gotta get ourselves a driver.
Hello? Hi, Sam. What can I do for you?
I wanna meet you, Dan. Do a little bit of talking.
Where?
East Chester Park. Five ways. Lexburg and Denver. You hearing me?
Yeah, I hear you. But you come alone. No hoods, mind.
No hoods, Dan. You have my word. What's he talking about? Don't bring your hoods. He wiped it on my hoods. Just you and me and our drivers.
Agreed. Got him, the knucklehead.
Gone, Salam.
Hey, Fizzy.
Hey, Bugsy.
How you doing? Still practicing?
Still practicing.
Have you seen Blousy around? I thought she'd be here for her audition.
Oh, well, she was here, but she went to go get some air. Got tired of waiting, I guess. But she did leave her bags here, so I guess she's coming back.
Thanks, Fizzy.
Suddenly, everyone's to be in show business.
Oh, hi, Tallulah.
He's busy, Bugsy. Why don't you have a drink while you're waiting?
Yeah, why not? I'll have a special on the rocks.
Hi, Bugsy.
Oh, hey, girls.
Okay, girls, go feed the ducks.
Aw, Tallulah!
I said beat it! Long time no see, Bugsy.
Well, you know who it is.
He used to come and see me every night.
I've been busy.
Doing what?
Oh, this and that.
Fizzy, will you quit the sweeping and hit the shoe leather?
Yes, ma'am.
You racist, you know that, Bugsy? I've always found you kind of special.
Careful, Tallulah. You're racing my motor.
Oh, come on, Bugsy. Give a girl a break.
You sure you got the right guy?
You're not like all those other saps.
I'm not.
You got lovely brown eyes. Things.
You'll be a lovely black guy if Fat Sam catches us.
Oh, come on, sugar. How about smearing my lipstick?
Careful, Tallulah. If you come any closer, I'll have to call my lawyer.
So call him.
Oh, hey, Blousy. I was looking for you.
Audition.
Hush your mouth, jerk. Okay, honey, I'm all ears.
I'm feeling fine, filled with emotion, stronger than wine. They give me the notion that this strange new feeling is something that you're feeling too. Matter of fact, I'm forced to admit it, caught in the act. And maybe we've hit it, if this strange new feeling is something that you're feeling.
Okay, honey, very nice, very nice. A little bit too contemporary for my taste, but all the same, very nice. You're hired.
That was great, Rousey. Real swell. I told you you could do it. Oh, what's the matter with you? I can explain all that Tallulah smooching.
Oh, Bugsy. How'd you like to earn yourself some green stuff?
Talk about cabbage. What's the catch?
No catch. This is job driving. Straightforward driving.
Knowing you, Sam, I'll be ducking and driving. How much?
200.
Cents?
No, dollars.
Dollars? Sounds like dangerous driving.
Nah, sure it might get a little hot, but you don't get $200 for driving a milk truck, Bugsy.
You got yourself a driver.
Good boy. Knuckles, fix me a drink, will you? Things are shaping up real fine, and I'm getting real thirsty. Bloodthirsty.
Oh, hey, Bangles. Is Blousy there?
She won't see you, Bugsy. She's mad. She was holding a torch for you, hiding the statue of Liberty.
Yeah, okay. Tell him I'm sick.
You're sick?
Yeah, sick of waiting.
I'll see what I can do, but don't count on me. Beat it, Wisey.
Look, I'll buy some flowers.
I'll see Tallulah gets them.
Stop being so smart, okay? They're for you.
Look, I've really got to go.
Okay, see you later.
Yeah, like 10 years later.
I got a job.
You don't get paid for standing in breadlines, Buster.
No, a legit job. We'll have enough money to go to the coast of Hollywood.
I don't believe you. You're putting me on.
It's the honest truth. I tell you.
2 minutes, everybody.
Look, I really got to go. Bye.
Okay. Blousy, trust me.
Sure.
I know. Never trust anyone that says trust me. But I was on a level, honest. I wanted to buy the 2 tickets. But first I had to help Sam and Looney. Looney Braganzi. Man, when they said he was off his trolley, they weren't kidding.
Quick, Bugsy, here he comes. Is he alone?
Yeah, it looks like it's just Dan and the driver.
Okay, get ready, Looney. Looney! Looney! Keep your head down. Keep out of sight. Wait till I give you the okay, right?
What can I do for you, Sam?
How about a small dose of straight talk, Dan?
Suits me.
You've been taking liberties, Dan.
I've been taking what's mine.
Trouble is, it belongs to me.
Two bad positions is 19th of the law, Sam.
Now hold on, Dan. I'm sure we can talk this over sensibly. We've been in this game a long time. You and me. After all, I'm a businessman.
You're a dime dozen gangster, Sam.
You button your lip, mister. I don't like your mouth. I have to have some respect.
You'd slit your own throat for 2 bits plus tax.
You'd keep wise cries behind your teeth, mister.
Keep talking.
I have my position to think of.
Right now, your position arranged with Plug Nickel.
You dirty rat, Dan.
You've been watching too many movies, Sam.
Okay, Looney, let him have it.
Quick, younger Charlie, to
get
on the
ground here.
Great, Bugsy. You did great. Here's $200 and 100 extra for your quick thinking.
Gee, thanks, Mrs. Ghetto.
Treat yourself to a new suit. Get rid of that laundry sack you're wearing. Here's the name of my tailor.
Thanks, Mrs. Ghetto.
Think nothing of it.
Stay my blanket is right cool.
Let's get out of here.
Hot-headed Bugsy makes his mind up. Don't mess with Bugsy or you'll wind up wishing you were left well enough alone. His abandoned boundaries are rolling stone, and he will leave you standing lonely, crying for his name, but it's known. Everybody loves that man, Bugsy Malone.
Till I die, I'll take what you give me and I won't ask why. I made a lot of friends in some exotic places. I don't remember names, but I remember faces. Lonely. Chase your troubles away. Oh, if you're lonely, you don't have to be lonely. When they talk about Tallulah, you know what they say. No one south of heaven's gonna treat you fine. Tallulah had its training in North Carolina. And soon I'll be gone. An open invitation is a road I'll travel on. I may even say goodbye because the words upset me. You may forgive my going, but you won't forget me. Lonely. Chase your troubles away. If you're lonely, you don't have to be lonely. When they talk about Tallulah, you know what they say. No one south of heaven's gonna treat you fine. Tallulah had a training in North Carolina.
Hi, Bugsy. Oh, I'll get it for you now. Blousey, it's for you. Send it, my love. Hello?
Hey, Blousey, it's Bugsy.
Where are you?
Oh, around. Listen, I can't talk right now, but I just wanted to say I made $200.
You mean you printed it yourself?
No, I earned it.
Swear to God.
Oh, this and that.
Who for?
Fat Sam.
Fat Sam gave you $200.
And a loan to his sedan for the afternoon.
I don't believe you. You printed me on.
No, it's the honest truth. Look, get yourself out of the Grand Slam in 10 minutes. Look for a snazzy sedan and a good-looking driver. And you'll see it's a very close resemblance to yours truly. Okay?
Okay, but you better not be putting me on, Buster.
Swear to God, I'm on a level. So long.
Date, Bugsy?
Sort of.
I'm giving up, guys. They're nothing but trouble, believe me. From now on, I'm looking for husbands, and I ain't getting too attached. I'm gonna treat them regular like a library book. What do you think of my dress, Kelly? Don't you think I look cute?
I don't know. It's...
Come on, Dottie. What do you think?
I don't know, Bagels. I think the color's wrong.
What are you talking about? Purple's my color. I always wear purple.
Matches the veins of your legs. Maybe it's the legs.
It's the latest legs. I read it in a magazine.
Maybe it's the frills. They stick out too much.
Matches.
You're just jealous. Can I help it if my looks are ahead of my time?
They're what?
Full of personality, character, kinda earthy.
Yeah, like a bucket of mud.
Mustard with onions, ketchup without.
Ketchup without. Do you really have $200?
Nope.
Oh yeah, you lied.
No, I have $198.10. I suppose two hot dogs.
You didn't do anything crooked now, did you?
Well, of course not. I just helped Mrs. Sammo with a little predicament.
Right, what was the next?
Oh, I nearly forgot.
What's this, a finger bowl?
No, it's a present, dummy.
For me?
Well, I didn't buy it for the audience.
Oh, Bugsy, it's wonderful, fantastic. What is it?
It's a postcard. Look, all of Hollywood stars.
If I could only get to Hollywood.
You can.
Oh, sure, I've heard that one wise guy in the front row of Roxy and 38th Street.
No, really, get to Hollywood. What, you want me to leave?
No, dummy, keep talking.
Right, I got $198.10 left. Right, what does that buy?
440 hot dogs.
No, two tickets, stupid.
Two tickets?
On the Super Chief.
The Super Chief?
The train, dummy, to Hollywood. Think about it.
I'm feeling fine, filled with emotion, stronger than wine. They give me the notion that this strange new feeling is something that you're feeling too. Two tickets?
Two tickets.
Matter of fact, I'm forced to admit it, caught in the act, and maybe we've hit it. If this strange new feeling is something that you're feeling too.
So, what's the answer?
Do you honestly think it'd be anything but yes? Oh, Bugsy Hollywood!
Oh, knock it off, will ya?
You're putting me on.
It's the honest truth. It's just if I don't get this sedan back to Fat Sam, my feet will look like yesterday's fettuccine.
Aha! I think I found something. Come and take a look at this, O'Jerry.
Can I see the script?
Practice this time, Captain.
I have? Tell me what you see, O'Jerry. Tell me what you see.
Your foot, Captain.
Not my foot, knucklehead. Under my foot. Tire marks.
Oh, that's a tire marker, right, Captain?
Too right is a tire mark, you Irish potato head. Get some plaster. We'll take a mold. There ought to be more marks somewhere. There are sure as eggs as eggs. More than one sedan around here. Hey, what's this?
Oh. Gee, Captain. I'm sorry, sir. I didn't see you there. It was an accident, honestly.
You dumb potato face, I jumped!
It was an accident, honestly. I just slipped. I didn't see you, Captain.
If I catch you or Deary, I'm going to punch that stupid Irish nose back to Tipperary!
Sure this is
going
to work, boss?
Of course it will not. In fact, enough to make me nervous.
Your mic's off. Switch it on. Of course it'll work. It looks like a Spurge gun, doesn't it? Doesn't it?
Sure, boss.
Anything Dan can do, Fat Sam can do better. Am I right or am I right?
You're right, boss.
Right. Now you ready, Knuckles?
I'm ready.
Okay, get set.
I'm set.
And fire!
Yeah.
Missed. Back to the drawing board, Knuckles. Knuckles? Speak to me. Knuckles? I'll get you this, you greasy little lizard. Poor Knuckles.
As you can see from this mess here, well, Fat Sam's life is looking kind of untight. And as for Knuckles, well, he definitely cast his chips. As for Smolsky, well, he started out with the intention of chasing O'Dreary back to County Cork. But what he forgot is that he had quick drying plaster poured all over him. And soon he looked like one of those dudes who'd occasionally pull out of the East River. Anyway. Hello? Is anybody there? Oh, are you hurt? Hello? You okay?
Take your money, mister?
Yeah, $200, 90 cents less. Sure nice of you to help me like that.
Oh, it was nothing.
You must be a fighter, right?
No.
But that was the best punch I've ever seen.
It was nothing.
You ever been coached?
Nope.
You ever thought about taking it up, as I mean, professionally?
Never thought about it.
No, you're not. You haven't?
Never had the chance.
I know someone that can help you. You heard of KG Joe?
Nope.
You heard of Slugger's Jim?
Nope.
You don't know much, do you?
Nope.
Put it there, Leroy. You got yourself a manager. Hey, KG Joe.
Hi, Bugsy. How you been, man?
Swell, KG Joe. Real swell. And you?
For me, yeah. Well, with this bunch of punch bags and things.
Well, KG Joe, I'd like you to meet the next heavyweight champion, Leroy. Meet KG Joe. KG Joe, meet Leroy Smith.
Ever been in the ring before, man?
Nope.
Do you want to be a boxer, huh?
Nope.
Of course he does. Look at those mitts. You ever seen such fists? Hit it there, Leroy. Ooh.
Smith.
With you showing him the ropes, he'll be a champion in no time.
All right, I'll give him a try. But I'll tell you now, he'll be no good unless he's got it.
It? What is it?
It's the difference between being a no good, hopeless slugger and being a champion.
If you haven't got it, then you haven't got it. So you wanna be a boxer in the golden ring? Can you punch like a southbound freight train? Tell me just one thing. Can you move in a whirl in a Hammondsburg ring if you need to?
Ooh, that's fast!
Can you bob, can you weave, can you fake and deceive when you need to? Well, you might as well quit if you haven't got it. So you wanna be a boxer, can you pass the test? I can tell you got it in you, I've trained the best. When you listen and you learn, there's honor, you can learn to defend your sin. When you do see the crown, you're a king, not a clown, a contender. But you might as well quit if you haven't got it.
Put him in the ring, Joe, love him many times. We can use a spread, Joe, push him around. We'll show him the ropes and destroy your hopes. Put him in the ring, Joe, give the guy a chance. Never in the swing, Joe, can we really dance? We'll pump him to bits, then he'll call it quits. For sure, Joe.
boxer, wanna be the champ. There's a golden boy inside you, not a punched out tramp. If you listen and you learn, there's honor you can earn to defend you. But when you do see the crown, you're a king, not a clown, a contender. But you might as well quit if you haven't got it. No answer.
Why don't you go ask me for help? Poisonally.
Poisonally?
Poisonally.
Poisonally. So long, lover boy. Hi, Bugsy.
Oh, Blousy. Oh.
I like my mat at my feet.
What are you doing here?
Put your flaps down, Tiger, else you'll take off. I got a message for you.
What's wrong with the Western Union?
Don't flatter yourself, Tiger. It's not me who's to talk to you, it's Fat Sam. Come on, let's go before your suspender belt strangles you.
No, I'm waiting for someone.
You are?
Yeah, Blousy. We're going to Hollywood.
Well, you know what they say. Don't pack anything you can't put on the train home. Sam's in trouble, Bugsy. And I'm sure he'll see that you're okay.
I'll be right there.
Sir, boss.
Yo, fix me a special on the rocks. It's all so fun. Find me a music. Yeah, find me.
Come here, let me shoot at me again. I saw a red light smile down your throat. I'm fair,
Mr. Higgins, how have you been?
Top dog, Mr. Big. Always have been, always will be.
Careful, boss, the floor's wet.
I shall move.
Swell, Mr. Gatto. And you?
Much a pleasure, Bugsy.
I'll have a special on the rocks.
Bugsy, I need your help. I'm your Jen. Danny Dan's beating down my neck, and any day now, I'm taking over my entire organization.
Well, you still got all this.
I have Danny Dan, this is waiting when I'm dying for a shoe shine.
Nothing?
Not a red cent.
There you go, one special on the rocks.
Jesus Christ.
You want to go fix your makeup?
But I already fixed it.
Then go make yourself more beautiful than you already are.
But you know that's impossible.
Lula.
Fine, I'll go manicure my gloves.
Bugsy, I need your help. My friend stole an army, my gang's gone, I'm a wreck. In short, I need you.
Me, Sam, but why me?
You got brains up here, not pretzels.
No rough stuff, hear my line.
Help me, I'll give you $200 for the $200 I already gave you.
Possible.
Dr. Smart.
No, impossible. I lost the last $200.
You lost $200 on a horse?
No, I got mugged.
So now you just want people around you, Dave, Bugsy. Here, $200 and $200 extra $200 for the ones you lost.
Thanks, Mrs. Ghetto.
We have a deal?
We got a deal.
Hello, is Bugsy there, please? Hello?
Is that phone ringing? Be right back, Sam.
Oh, sure thing, Bugsy. Take it around. Treat this place as your own. For a moment, for you, do whatever you like. After all, Kenny Daddy is
ready to send
a phone. Hello? Bugsy, is that you? Where are you? We said 8:30 and you're an hour late.
Oh, something came up.
Like what?
Like business.
Oh yeah, with Tallulah.
No, not with Tallulah.
Did you get the tickets?
No, not yet.
But you promised me.
I told you, something came up. This is business, it can't wait. Hollywood can.
An hour I've been waiting here, Bugsy. When you first didn't show, I give you the benefit of the doubt. And then I got nervous, and I called every pool hall dive in the phone book. And they hadn't seen you. But boy, did they all know you.
Oh, get off, Tallulah.
You rat, you two-time in bog Irish meatball wop. Only a fool, like fools before me. I always think with my heart. Only a fool. That same old story. Seems I was born for the part. It's a lesson that I've learned, and a page I should have turned. I shouldn't cry, but I do. Like an ordinary fool, when her ordinary dreams fall. I mistaken good looks and laughs for good news. How many times have I mistaken good looks and laughs for the blues? When a road I've walked before ends alone at my front door, I shouldn't cry, but I do. Like an ordinary fool, when her ordinary dreams fall through.
Hey, Leroy! Wake up! Come on, Leroy!
Who is it? What do you want?
It's me, Leroy, Bugsy. We got a job.
You got me a crock of turn already?
No, this is a different kind of job.
I'm tired, Bugsy. Come back in the morning.
The morning will be too late. We'll be working for Fat Sam's, the ghetto. You'll be hitting Dandy down where it hurts. There's $200 in it for you.
I'll do it. Oh.
Come on, you guys. This place is like a morgue. Let's have a little optimism here. How about some music? Oh, hi, Blousy. Thought you was on your way to the coast.
It fell through.
Shame. Tough.
Mr. Cicada, do you think I could have my job back?
Sure, honey. Go right in. The more the merrier.
Hi, Blousy. Did you miss your train?
Hi, Blousy. What happened? Did I let you down?
Hi, Blousy. How you been? Did you ever see a board carry a torch so high?
Yeah, the Statue of Liberty.
Splurge guns. That must be where they keep the guns. Look what it says on the side of the truck.
I can't.
What, you can't read?
No, it's a little short sighted. What does it say?
It says splurge guns. Splurge import. Oh. This must be where they keep the guns.
Well, let's go, come on.
Whoa, 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 hold your horses. There must be a dozen guards. Yeah, look. Two on the front, two on the top, and two on the sides. What are we gonna do, Leroy?
Go home?
There must be another way in.
Don't be stupid, Bugsy. We'll never slug away to that far.
Oh, I guess you're right. We need an army to get to there.
No armies around here?
What's that? Listen. That's wound up. Think of all the times you waste, and time's a precious thing to let roll by. Sure, you hit the bottom, but remember you'll be building from the ground up. Every day's another step that leads you even closer to the sky. So give it a try. You don't have to sit around depressed about the way that love's deceived you. Fortune sailed away, you missed the boat and found that you'd been left behind. Fight and fight some more until you know the world is ready to receive you. Lady luck is fickle, but a lady is allowed to change her mind. Sit around complaining about the way your life was wound up.
Down, 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 down.
So be a man, you know you can't be certain that you lose until you try. Sit around complaining about the way your life is wound up. So be a man, you know you can't be certain that you lose until you try. So give it a try. Are you with me?
Yeah!
Well, let's go! There they are, all ready for the take-in. Get Babyface.
Get Babyface.
Get Babyface.
Get Babyface.
Get
Babyface.
Get Babyface.
Get Babyface.
Give this to Babyface.
Give this to Babyface.
Give this to Babyface.
Give this to Babyface.
No thanks. Oh, come on, Babyface, get out there.
Okay, guys. This is the cabin that's going to take the lid off City Hall. This is the big one.
The big one.
The shakedown.
Shakedown.
The payoff.
The payoff.
It's got to be good, it's got to be neat, it's got to be quick.
It's got to be good, got to be neat, got to be
quick. Quit repeating what I say. Anyways, you shouldn't have any trouble. It's only Sam and a few dance ball girls. Remember, when you get inside the speakeasy, keep those fingers pumping, because it'll be history you'll be writing.
Three cheers for Dandy Dan! Hip hip!
Hooray!
Hip hip!
Hooray!
Hip hip!
Hooray!
Too kind, you guys. Now Fat Sam's Grand Slam.
Right, Leroy, Babyface, make sure you're hidden. Right, you're gonna get out of the way, or else I'm gonna take someone else to Hollywood.
Sure, Bugsy.
Two tickets to Hollywood.
Oh, Bugsy!
Bugsy!
Yeah, yeah. Right, everybody act normal. Girls, hit it. Razzmatazz, and hit the ivories.
Anybody wins, anybody will soon walk through that door. Act that dance slam. Speak easy. Oh, table to five, you table edge room for just one more. Act that dance slam. Speak easy. Once you get here, feel the chill like they say in a phone. That's handy humble, but it's your home, see home. Learn to play new games and play new life and like your home. Each night is found new. Rooms are buzzing, stores are cousin. Look around the present of the moon.
Anything that we wanted to be, and it's not too late to change. I'd be delighted to give it some thought. Maybe you'd agree that we really are. 2, 3, 4.
We could have been anything that we wanted to be. Yes, that decision was us. Anything you tried it, we'll lose it, we'll find it. Let a friendship double up our powers. We could have been anything that we wanted to be, but I'm not saying we should. But if you try it, we'll learn to abide it. We'll be the best at being good guys. Flowers of the earth. Who could even get so much a real friend is worth? But when guys shake an open hand, maybe we'll be trusting if we learn to understand. No doubt about it, it must be worthwhile to take the pinch to make you smile. We could have been anything that we wanted to be. Yes, that decision was ours.
Yeah, yeah.